No matter where we're getting our ones and zeros from, we have to turn those ones and zeros into digital information and back again. So what represents a zero and what represents a one? That's called encoding, and there are different ways that we can do it. We have something called unipolar encoding. In the case of unipolar encoding, I can say, well, this is no voltage at all down here on this sort of orange line, and this is some voltage up here. And when I have a one, I will just make that a voltage, and when I have a zero, I'll make it no voltage. So voltage, no voltage. Sounds simple enough, just like a switch. It sounds simple, but there are a couple of problems. First of all, is that if there's a zero, how do I tell if that means a bit or if it means I just don't have any signal? A zero bit is very different from no signal at all, but they look the same to this thing. The second problem is if I have a large number of ones and zeros, see, these little ticks here are time, and these are ticking off time. So let's say that this duration here is a millisecond. Well, what happens if I have a long string of ones or a long string of zeros? I might lose that synchronization. Well, we're going to use something called bipolar encoding to solve problem number one. So with bipolar encoding, here's my zero line. I don't have zero. So now if I have no signal, it would be zero, and I would know that there are no zeros and ones. So I have a negative voltage for zero, a positive voltage for one. Negative for zero, positive for one. This still does not solve the second problem. If I have a string of ones or a string of zeros, I could lose that synchronization. One way we can get around that with either bipolar or unipolar encoding is through something called RZ, or return to zero. So in this case, we have RZ unipolar. So when I have a voltage, notice that this voltage here goes through a certain period of time, and then halfway through that time period drops back to zero. Now here, I've got this same, I've got a zero bit, and there's no voltage at all. And of course, there's nothing to return to. So I'm only returning here when there's a one. In bipolar, it's even better. In bipolar, I stay at zero. When there's a one bit, it goes up and back down. When there's a zero bit, it goes down and back up. So that actually works pretty well for us. We actually have a special case of RZ bipolar. And that is something we call Manchester encoding, which is very, very popular today. Manchester encoding is a little bit different. Rather than high being one and low being zero or vice versa, what we have is the change representing zero or one. So if I change from, say, high to low, that represents one. And then when I change from low to high, that represents zero. And you may notice in here that we have to return it. So here's two ones. I have a high voltage, I return to zero, and then I have a high voltage, and I return to zero again. So no matter which way we go, we return to zero every time. And this helps helps get by both problems. There is also something called NRZ. Unipolar and bipolar, the way I described them in earlier slides, are NRZ types, non-return to zero. So it's just the opposite of return to zero. It's just sort of a generic term. All right, thank you very much.